Welcome back to my channel again. So few days back we have seen the rules of direct and indirect speech. So what all rules we have to follow while we are doing the direct and indirect or the change in narration. Today we are going to do the exercises related to that. First we will start with the statement exercises. After all we will do the interrogative sentences. So I have given here the questions related to the direct speech and the answers will be So once again, as part of the revision, we will do what we have seen in the rules of the direct and indirect. The first rule is the change in the tense. As I told you that the present tense will change into past, as simple present into simple past, present continuous into past continuous, present perfect into past perfect. And if the simple past is asked, it will change into past perfect. Then again, if the past continuous is asked, it will be changed into past perfect continuous. Okay, so these are the tenses what we have seen. Then again, the change in the pronoun. If the first person pronoun is given, we will change according to the subject. And if second person pronoun is given, we will change according to the object. And if the third person pronoun is given, then there will be no change. In that way, we have seen the change in the pronoun. And change in the auxiliaries or the time. Okay, so these are the rules what we have seen. Now let us move towards the example. So moving towards example, before that we will see what all rules we have to keep in our mind while we are learning the statements. So the first statement is, if the said to is given in the direct speech, we have to change it into told. That is the first one. Said to is given, we will change it into the told. Okay. Then again the next one, inverted commas in the question, it will be removed. In the answer there will be no inverted commas. So once the inverted comma is removed, we have to connect the sentences. So how will we connect the sentence? Using a conjunction, that. So the conjunction that is used to connect both the sentences. Comma and inverted comma will be removed and conjunction that will be used. Then again the next one, what we have taught, change in the pronoun, the tenses and all. Okay, so let us see for the first one. First question is, Ramu said, I saw a lion in the forest. This is the first one. Ramu said, again comma, I saw a lion in the forest. So first, if said to is given, then only you have to change tall. If said is given, the same way you have to write. Okay. So how will we start the answer? Ramu said. Then I have to remove the comma and I have to remove the inverted commas. For that, what I should do? I'll use the conjunction that. Ramu said that. Then this I, okay, so I we have to use in the same way. Ramu said that. So is given here, right? So means which tense? It is the simple past tense. We know that so is in simple past. So whenever the simple past is asked, what we have to do? We have to change it to past perfect. So here first we have to change the I. I is the first person pronoun. If the first person pronoun is given, we will change according to the subject. What is the subject given here? Ramu. So the pronoun we have to use is he. Ramu is a masculine gender, so we'll use he. So Ramu said that he. Then so, it is in simple past, we will change it into past perfect. Had. So its third form is seen. Okay, how it become had seen? Had plus past participle form of the verb. That is a form of past perfect. So had seen. So Ramu said that he had seen. Then again the rest, a lion in the forest. Okay. So this is the answer for the first one. Ramu said that he had seen a lion in the forest. So I think this is clear. Then again we will move towards the second one. Sadhir said to me, I am very happy here. Sadhir said to me, I am very happy here. So you can see the said to there. The word said to is used. So how we will change the said to? We will change it as told. So how should we start our answer? Sadhir told. So instead of the said to, I have used the word told. Sadhir told that. This I will be changed according to the subject. Subject here is Satish. Satish is masculine, so we will change it as he. The pronoun used, Satish told that he, am very happy here. It is given in present, so we have to change it into the past. Present past. Past only will change into past perfect. So simply it is given in the simple present or the present continuous, we will change it directly into the past. So what we have to use here? He was very happy. Then here it will become there. Okay, so this is the answer. So I have removed the inverted comma, the conjunction that is used. And I change according to the subject. If first person pronoun is given, change according to the subject. If second person pronoun you is given, change according to the object. Okay. So we have written Satish told that he was very happy there. Then again see the next one. He said I can do this work. He said I can do this work. So how will we change? He said that I. Again we have to see the I. I is the first person, so we'll change according to he. He said that he can. What is the past form of can? It is could. C-O-U-L-D, could. He said that he could do that work. Because this will become that. Then put the full stop. He said that he could do that work. Then again see the last one. Last one again. Renu said to me, I was washing the clothes. Renu said to me, I was washing the clothes. So how will we change that? Renu said to will become tall. Renu's tall. What Renu tall? That I was washing the clothes. Okay, so Renu tall me. Then it will become the that. The conjunction is used to remove the inverted comma and the comma. Then after that, see the I is here. I we have to change according to the subject. Renu is the feminine gender here. So we will use she. So what will be the word used? Renu told me that she was washing. That is past continuous. So past perfect continuous. So what it become? She had been washing the clothes. She had been washing the clothes. Renu told me that she had been washing the clothes. Yes, here I left the me. Satish told me that he was very happy. Okay, so this is the way. So the things what you have to remember while we are writing the statement is said to will become tall. If said is given, write the said itself. And inverted commas remove. Conjunction that is used to connect both the parts of the sentence. And change in the pronoun and the tenses. Simply, if the simple present is given, it will become simple past. Then present continuous, past continuous, and simple past is will become past perfect. And the last one is past continuous will become past perfect continuous. Again, come back to the exercises of the number 5. She said, "I am not well." She said, "I am not well." So how should we change it? He said that. Again, I we will change according to she. She said that. She am not well. It will change as she was not well. Okay, this was according to the am. Am is given in present tense. We will change it into was in the past tense. Again, see the next one. He said to Sita, I have passed the test. He said to will become told. He told Sita that I. Change according to the subject. What is the subject? Subject is he. So we'll change according to the subject he. So the sentence will become he told Sita that he have passed will become had passed the test. Again, so the next one. I said to my friend, he has been working very hard. I said to my friend will become told. My friend that it is given he. Hana, so it is
given and already it is given in the third person, then we can write it according to that. I told my friend that he has been, will become, had been working very hard. Okay. I told my friend that he had been working very hard. I am not saying the he. Why? He is in the third person. If the third person is given, there will be no change. First person will change according to the subject. Second person, you, will change according to the object. If the third person is given after the comma, when the reporting verb is starting, you know, at that time when the, what we say, the he, the third person, he or she will be given, then we will write the same. We will not make any changes in the third person. That is why I written the he here. I told my friend that he had been working very hard. I said I agree to what he said. So how should I change? I said that. Again I will write the I. I said that I. Agree will become agreed to what he, here is a verb, said. We will change the said. Said is in the simple past. We have to change it into past perfect. What he had said. Okay. I said that. I agree to what he had said. Now let us see the last one. Student said to the teacher, I am sorry that I am late. So in change the narration, that way the board the question is coming. So the two or three sentences will be given. So you have to change it. The interrogation will be there. Statement will be there. So change according to the rules. Okay. So this is the last word. The student said to the teacher, I am sorry that I am late. So how will we start? The student told the teacher that I am sorry that I am late. So how should we write? That he, am sorry will become was. That he was sorry that he was late. Okay. So I am sorry. The am is in the present. We have changed it to was. He was. How the he came? I is given. Na? We change according to the subject. What is the subject? The student. Okay. So I make it he. That he was sorry that I am late will become he was late. So in this way we have to write the statements. Now we'll move towards the interrogative sentences. How we will change the direct sentence into indirect in the interrogative rules. Yes. Now we are going to start with the interrogative sentences. So let us see what are the rules of the interrogative. Interrogative in the sense questions. Okay. So if said is asked, we will change it into asked. Said will become asked. That is the first one. If interrogative is given, in interrogative sentences, we have to change it into the statement. First, the subject will be written and the verb follows that. In the examples, it will be clear for you. Just go through this. If the interrogative sentences, we have to change it into a statement, we will write the subject at first, then after that, we will write the verb. The third one is in the yes or no question. If the question is given in yes or no, if or whether will be asked. Then the next one, that the conjunction will not be used in the interrogative. In the statement, we have used that. But here, we will not use the conjunction that. WH word, question word will be as when, where, who, what. If it will be there, it serves as a conjunction. In the sense, it will be repeated and it serves as a conjunction. The same word will be repeated and serves as a conjunction to connect the both. And if do or does or did is given in a positive sentence, in the positive question form, and it will be drop. Okay, it will be drop. We will not write it in the sentence. So we'll move towards the sentence and it will be more clear for you. So the first one is, I said to him, where are you going? This is my first question. I said to him, where are you going? So how should we write? First I will write I. Said to will be changed as ask. I ask him. Okay. Then after that what we have to do? I asked him, WH question is given. So I told you that if the WH question will be given, it will be repeated and it serves as a conjunction. So we can repeat the same. So I'll write the where here. So it is a conjunction, so these things will be removed. I ask him where, Then after that, subject plus verb. So see, the subject is given you. You, the pronoun, we have to change you. See, it is second person. So if the second person is there, we will change according to the object. What is object given here? Him. So the pronoun we have to write is he. I think it is clear. If the second person pronoun is given, we will change it according to the object. First person pronoun is given I, then we will change it according to the subject. Third person pronoun he, she is given, we will change it in the same. That means there will be no change, the same he will be written in the third person. So you, I have changed according to the object him, then I have written here he. So why I have written the he? See, subject plus verb. First I have to write the subject. So the subject he is written. Then are, it will be changed as was. Present will become past. Where he was going. Okay, then the full stop. No question mark. Question mark and inverted comma will be removed and the full stop will come. I think the first one is clear. I asked him where he was going. So set to will become ask. Where I have written, if WH question word comes, it will be repeated and serve as a conjunction. Conjunction means what? Connecting two words. Two words we have to connect, two sentences we can connect. So here it serves as where. And he was, why I have written, subject plus verb, that is the form. First we have to write the subject and again the verb, then the rest. See the next one. He said to me, will you go there? How will we write that? He asked me. See the question, will you go there? It is a yes or no question. Will you go there? Yes. Will you go there? No. The answer is yes or no. So in such cases, we will use if or whether. In such cases, we will use if or whether. So you have to learn this rules. Okay, then only you can do the sentence, otherwise the mistake will be there. So if or whether, we have to use either if or whether. So how should I start? He asked me, then after that I have done if. Okay, so this things will be removed, the comma and the inverted comma. He asked me if you, it will be changed according to the object. What is object here? Me. If I will be the pronoun for me, hai na? So we have written I there. If I, then will become would go there. Okay, so this is my answer. He asked me if I would go there. Why I have used the if? Because it is a yes or no question. Now move towards the third one. My friend said to Deepak, have you ever been to Agra? So I will write, my friend asked Deepak. Okay, I have written the first part. Then I have to change the comma and the inverted commas here. So what I will do, I'll see what type of question it is. Have you ever been to Agra? Answer is yes or no, either yes or no. So it is again yes or no question. So I have to use either if or whether. So I will use the if. My friend asked Deepak, if you, change the you according to the object. Object is Deepak. So Deepak is masculine, na? So we'll use he. My friend asked Deepak if he, have will become had. Then the rest, ever, he had ever been to Agra. Then again the next one. I said to him, did you enjoy the movie? I said to him, did you enjoy the movie? This is the last one what I have written here. So what I should do? First I have to write I. Said to will become ask. I ask him. Then, if do, does or did come in a positive way, in the positive question sentence, we have to drop it. That means we will not write it. Did you know that, Anna? Did means it is in the past form. So we have to write according to that the verb. What tense we will write? If it is simple past, we have to change it into past perfect. In that way we have to write. I asked him, then did is given here, so we have to change that, drop that did. So for this, I'll use the if. Why? Because it is again yes or no question. Did you enjoy the movie? Answer will be either yes or no. So again, if or whether. So I have to use the if. Then I have to drop this did. I have to remove this did. Instead of the did, what I have to do? What is the tense? The simple past. So I have to change it into past perfect. I asked him if you. You, I have to change according to him. What? You is the second person pronoun. Change according to the object. So what is the object? Him. It will become he. If he, did will become had. Okay, why had it come? है ना, डिड मीन सिंपल पास्ट, पास्ट परफेक्ट. इफ ही हैड एंजॉयड द मूवी, आई थिंक दिस क्लियर फॉर यू. आई आस्क हिम इफ यू विल बिकम ही हियर वाई सेकेंड पर्सन चेंज अकॉर्डिंग टू द ऑब्जेक्ट. So him will become he. Then did as in the simple past, we will change into past perfect. Form is had plus past participle. So had like clear. Enjoy will become enjoyed the movie. I think this is clear. Now we'll do more examples related to that. Yes. Again, come back to the next one. I said to her, "Do you know him?" I said to her, "Do you know him?" Again, see my question here. Do does or did come, we have to drop it if it is a positive sentence. Here the sentence is given as positive, so we have to drop. So how should we write? I ask her, then I'll use if as a conjunction. If you, I have to change according to the object is her. It is a feminine gender, so we will use she. This masculine he and feminine we will use she. So what will we write here? I asked her if. Then drop the do. Do ko humko remove karna. I have to drop the do. So do will not be repeated. I ask her if she know is given. This is the present. We have to change it to the past. It will become new. If she knew him. I ask her if she knew him. I think this is clear. Again, the second next one. He said to me, will you listen to me? He ask me. Said to will be changed as ask. Then after that we have to see what type of question is given here. And now he said to me, will you listen to me? That is a yes or no question. So what we have to do? Change this comma and inverted comma using if. He asked me if you change according to me. He asked me if I will become would. I would listen to her, or you can write him, both is right. Okay, me is given, either it will be feminine or masculine. He asked me if I would listen to him. Next one, I said to him, when will you go there? Here again the when, the question word when is given. I said to him, when will you go there? So how should we write? I said to him, I asked him, remote, and the question WH question word, it will be repeated and serves as a conjunction. So I'll repeat the word. I asked him when you, him, so you will become he, when he will become would, when he would go there. Okay. I asked him when he would go there. He said to me, how is your father? He said to me, how is your father? So what, how will we write? He asked me. See, only the WH question serves as a conjunction. Here, how is given, so we can do the same in the how. So will we write, he asked me how your father will become my father. Okay, how my father is will become was. How my father was. See, normally how was my father? That mistake, children usually make this mistake. First they will write the verb, then afterwards they will write the subject. But in the interrogative question word, first the subject will come and the verb while we are changing the statement. We are changing the statement. First we have to write the subject, then the verb. In question only we will write the verb and after that the subject will come. Okay, so in that way you have to change. So I think this part is clear for you. So today we have seen the statements and also the interrogative form. Okay.